Alrighty, boys and girls, welcome back. So this is video 2 of 2, and this is the shootout between something old and something new. And what we have here is we have the old Marshall Lead 12. This is the head. We have the new Marshall MG series. This happens to be the Zach Wild series, but I've heard both, and they're, you know, they're somewhat in the same ballpark in regards to underlying tone. So again, something old, Lead 12, something new, the Marshall MG series. Now, what I'm doing here, in case you didn't see video 1, I'm toggling back and forth between both heads so you could hear both with this here Radial Engineering's tone bone. They have the head bone, which is the solid state head switcher. This will allow me to use one cabinet, boys and girls. If you have watched any of my other videos and listened to some of the feedback, one of the common feedback remarks I get is that the tone is different because the speakers are placed differently and the camera is hearing it differently. So what I've done here is the camera is hearing the same sound at the same position for both heads. This here headbone is will allow me to take two heads and direct the output to one cabinet. So I have a Marshall 1x10. Typically you'd buy these with a 1x10, and to be speaker agnostic, it's not the speaker that would come with the Lead 12, it's not the speaker that would come with the MG. Interestingly enough, the speaker that came with the Lead 12 was only available for the Lead 12, and the speaker that comes with the MG is a no-named MG series speaker. So what I've done was I put a Celestion G10, which is readily available. I put it in a 1x10 closed back Marshall cabinet, and again using the radial headbone to toggle back and forth, and you be the judge. You let me know which one you like best. Okay? So starting on the left, the Lead 12. I set this one, gain is all the way up, treble is at about 3 o'clock, mid is right in the middle, and bass is all the way up. And it's pretty much the same thing on the MG series. Bass is all the way up, mids are in the middle, and treble is right around 3 o'clock. Just to keep apples to apples, the Lead 12 doesn't have reverb, so the reverb is not on the Marshall MG series. And the Marshall MG, the Zach Wild has this FDD, I don't recall what it stands for, but it's basically a presence control, and I'm keeping that off also. So, without further ado, let's hear how the Lead 12 sounds. Now the MG series. Now the Lead 12. The MG series. So what I'm hearing here, boys and girls, I'm hearing that the Lead 12 is much more articulate, less muddy than your typical amp that you would find today. This MG series, as much as I love Marshall, it just sounds like every other high gain amp today. It's very mushy, it's very muddy, which is great if you love high gain, but when you throw more gain in the mix, you lose articulation. So if you want the articulation, I would say invest your dollars and buy a used Lead 12 on eBay. The underlying tone sounds the same, but you get the articulation here. On the MG series, which is the new one, you definitely get the I hate to say the word mushy, but it's a mushy kind of gain. And again, the gear here was very simple. Vintage Marshall Lead 12. MG series, this happens to be Zach Wild by Marshall. All accomplished by using the radial headbone, solid state switcher to take two heads, put it into one cabinet, and the cabinet is a 1x10 Celestion G10 series, and doing all the above with, if you've watched my other videos, you've seen this one before. This one here is the Mynaric Lotus. Alright, well, I hope you enjoyed the video, and as always, please send me your thoughts. Thank you.